For game three, at least we get to play first. Really, I'm starting to desire the 17th land that I had in my original list. Because if, well, any of the non-Mox Opal cards would have been a land, this would have been an excellent draw. And now I'm afraid I just have to mulligan. This is better. I mean, I have mana. All the mana I need. Three mana sources, actually. Volt Scourge and Ansel Artifact. That's going to be my game plan. It is a game plan that's susceptible to both Dismember and Creeping Corrosion. But, hey, a game plan is a game plan, so we keep. How do I do this? Might as well cast the Ornithopter. You can never go wrong with an Ornithopter. The Mox. The Drum. And now we have Metalcraft, so we can just cast this and not even pay life. It's beautiful. Come on, tap for black. Yes. Well, that worked. Turn one, I have one card remaining in hand. Go! I love Affinity. Experiment one, fine. Thoughtseize would be perfect here, then I can take out his Dismember. Looks like it's time to go all in. And I could hatch my bets and put Ansel Artifact on Ornithopter, because then. Well, it's obviously way better against something like a Dismember. Then if he has Dismember, I still have a Volt Scourge remaining. But I'm kind of afraid that I won't be able to win the damage race that way. Right, if I put Ansel Artifact on Ornithopter, or maybe on the Drum, or like, no, I should put it on Ornithopter for flying. Then I have a 4-turn clock. I do gain some life in the meantime, and I guess I have a block at some point. But I can easily see my opponent erasing that with just a bunch of strength good guys and then rancors and stuff. So, and even if like I put the Ansel Artifact on Ornithopter and he dismembers it, well, I only have a Volt Scourge and that's also doubtful that it will win the game. So I guess I just have to put it on here and hope. Because it seems more likely that my opponent has a draw where has a draw where he might be able to win a damage race, but doesn't have Dismember or Creeping Corrosion. So yeah, you can see it as a gamble, but it's playing does Unravel the Aether. Well, I guess that's kind of a dismember, but doesn't lose my opponent any life. Fine. Well, I guess if he was gonna do this, he might as well have attacked first to bluff Finds of Lastwood. I would have still blocked, but yeah, Darksteel Citadel. So our next plan is to win with poison. It might work if I draw a Cranial Plating or an Arcbound Ravager in maybe my next draw step or the one after that. Militant, fine. I mean, this is kind of the downside of Ansel Artifact, obviously. When the opponents have 1-for-1 spot removal spells that deal with artifacts, then, especially if you're mulliganing and on the play, as I was in this game, yeah, you just lose two threats to one card, and now, well, you're in a position that I'm in, where it's difficult to do anything. Come on. Arcbound Ravager. Nope. Emmet Knight. I guess we'll cast it. Well, my opponent is already up to 2 poison here. So if I draw an Arcbound Ravager on the next turn, I can sacrifice 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 artifacts to it. Yeah, that would actually be lethal, exactly. So that's a good reason not to jump block here. Mean, if I don't jump block with Ornithopter now, I can always jump block on the next turn. I guess the more interesting question is, do I block with Memnite over here? Because that's not a jump block, that's kind of a trade. I think the answer to that is yes. If I draw Arcbound Ravager on the next turn, I'm a favorite to win the game, whether or not it's immediately lethal or whether I need a turn in addition to that. And by blocking here, maybe I actually get an additional turn to draw the Arcbound Ravager. So this seems fine to me. And if he has some kind of pump spell, I want to use that here, that's also fine. That's a pump spell that doesn't add power to a creature that I didn't block. No pump spells, so far so good. He probably doesn't even have additional. Well, definitely not something like a Leatherback Bailoth. He would have played that before combat to pump his experiment one. He could still have a bunch of like additional Duskers or random green dorks. I don't think he has Creeping Corrosion. He should have just played that before combat. Or, well, actually, if he has Creeping Corrosion, he shouldn't play it at all. He should just wait until I draw a Cranial Plating, maybe. And take that one out, though. Nah, if there's actually a Cranial Plating on top of my deck, he should have played a Creeping Corrosion. Because just allowing me to get like a +6 poison for one turn is a bit too dangerous. And if you're Creeping Corrosion here, I don't even have the mana for a plating. So I expect that his hand is, well, just a bunch of creatures. But then, why is my opponent thinking about his plays? Maybe he has a Dismember and is thinking about whether or not to leave up Dismember in mana, or I don't know, put two Duskers in play. We'll see. And I figured it out. My opponent lost the connection to the game, which is shown here in this chat log, which always open in a, for me, completely non-intuitive different window that I, well, rarely check. But we're just waiting for our opponent to come back to the game, rather than him having like a super difficult decision on which card to play. Well, our opponent returned. And with him, a Scavenging Ooze. Which is fine. It's gonna be, well, a 4-4, potentially. I don't care much about the life gain, because I was planning on killing him with poison anyway. Ensoul Artifact, interesting. Well, I can put Ensoul Artifact on Inkmoth Nexus for a turn. And then I hit for 5 poison. It will fall off at the end of the turn, but you essentially get like a, well, 2 mana +4 poison card here. And it might be worth actually. I mean, I have some options. I can either put it on the Nexus for a turn, and then if I draw another Ensoul Artifact on the next turn, well, that's going to be lethal via poison. I could also put Ensoul Artifact on Darksteel Citadel. Just have that as a big blocker, staving off his attacks. I think I like that better. It just gives me more time to draw into I guess either cranial plating or Archbund Ravager, which are the more reliable ways to to deal a lot of poison damage. Because I mean, if I put the Ancel Artifact on here now, I attack him down to 7 poison, but then I just immediately need to draw something because I can jump for a turn, but then he probably draws another creature, and I'm just most likely gonna be dead if I don't draw any other boost effect like Ancel Artifact or Ravager or Plating. Then yeah, I'm just not winning the damage race. But putting the Ancel Artifact on the Citadel just gives me a lot more time and also makes other draws more live. So I think I like that line. The question is, can I somehow play Ancel Artifact on here and have mana up to attack with Inkmod Nexus? Even with this Mox Opal, the answer to that is no. Abu. Well, sucks. Not much I can do about this. Unravel the Aether is actually the perfect answer to Ancel Artifact on Darksteel Citadel. My opponent is really ahead of the meta game here. Yep, it'll work. So now I'm pretty far behind. There actually was like a third play that I could have made that I didn't mention, which is to put Ancel Artifact on Ornithopter and go for like a 3-turn kill. But again, I don't think I can race this board with like a 3-turn Ornithopter kill, even with like an Inkmod Nexus jump block. So here, well, I need to top deck like crazy. I guess now I'm happy that there's Thoughtcast in my deck, so I can somehow chain Thoughtcast into Thoughtcast and, I don't know, get something that resembles a board. I think I just take the damage here because one of my outs is Archbound Ravager, and I probably need to sacrifice Archbound Ornithopter to the Archbound Ravager in order to make that an out. Now, so Ooze is gonna grow into a big size, which is obviously another reason not to put the Ancel Artifact on the Ornithopter, by the way. And I really need to draw something on the next turn. The double Unravel the Aether has really proven its worth against my double Ancel Artifact. Yeah, that's not gonna do it. I guess I can jump, jump, jump. But then how do I win? Actually, how do I even jump, jump, jump? I need to tap Ornithopter for the Springleaf Drum, but then I have one fewer attacker, blocker. Yep, I'm just completely dead here. So, about the concede, just looking at the game, Ancel Artifact wasn't that good, and this indicates that Unravel the Aether, or just artifact removal, spot removal in general, is a reason not to max out on Ancel artifacts in the deck. At the same time, well, Creeping Corrosion still is quite the beating, and maybe I would have been able to, well, win this one if those Ancel artifacts had been something like Edge Champions, or at least would have been in a much better position, or if I had more lands in my hand. In my opening hand, I mean, where I had to mulligan a 0 land hand, I believe, indicating that 16 lands is sometimes not enough. Well, just some things to keep in mind, as always, how I try to think back of the games and reevaluate things in order to figure out how to build the best version of Affinity. But this match, nope, we're not winning. See you for round 2.